React Native developers, the following renderings are entirely built with React Native Ski App. They run seamlessly on iOS and Android, and can also perfectly match Liquid Glass designs from Figma. I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. In this video, we're going to explore how to build the Liquid Glass effect using React Native Skia. And I am very excited about this recipe because it's using all the ingredients we know and love from React Native Skia. First, there is a liquid shape aspect. We're going to build it using SDFs and the smooth minimum to nicely blend between shapes. We've already explored this technique in the Game On announcement. This is how we were able to achieve the nice liquid Skia logo reveal, as well as in the Shaders Gambit video, where we could nicely blend parts of the piece together. And then there are backdrop filters that we know and love from React Native Skia. We already had a video on glass morphism where we showed that we don't apply the filter on the shape itself, but on rather what's behind the shape. And already in the video back then, we had alluded to the fact that we could use a different image filter than a blur. But of course, then we didn't have such creative ideas of what you could do with it. And Apple here came up with something very clever. Generally speaking, when we use a backdrop filter, we clip the shape using often a path. But of course, here, since our geometry is liquid, we're going to use an advanced image filter. We're going to use a blend image filter to nicely clip the backdrop filter. So that's a new technique we're going to look at. And we can mimic the transmission of the light using a shader and using a shader as an image filter, which is also a technique that we explored in the previous video, the Severance tutorial, where we had built a custom CRT effect using a shader that we would use then as an image filter. And ShaderToy has a really interesting collection of liquid glass effects that we're going to have a look at. And then I had a look at what people are doing on the web. On the web, the graphic primitives tend to be siloed with each other. So you can use CSS to apply a backdrop filter. You can not really build a shader as an image filter. You can use an SVG filter as a backdrop filter only on some browsers, I think maybe Google Chrome and maybe Firefox. And I did find some really creative ways that people are building the liquid glass effect on the web, and they're using a displacement map. So we're going to shade the shape with different colors, which are going to indicate how much the background should be displaced on the X and Y axis, and how much, depending on the position of the shape, we're going to deform the image. Previously on the channel, we had mentioned how core graphic web APIs are quite siloed with one another, and we had shot some motivational examples, but clearly here Liquid Glass is really a strong motivational example of why you really need to break silos between web graphic APIs, because you really need to put everything together. Backdrop filters, writing an image filter as a shader, and so on. Last year, Fernando Cerbonici showed a demo of the HTML content of a web page being available as a texture. And this, of course, would be extremely useful in the context of the Liquid Glass example. And then there is the elephant in the room. The elephant in the room is that, of course, these effects only work if the content we're filtering is produced by React Native Skia. A while back, we had released a feature called Snapshot Views, where we can access the content of native views as an image in React Native Skia. And we had showed some examples of the kind of user experiences you can build with it. And we think some of the examples are quite compelling. But so far, these only work if the native view content is static. And of course, if we were to implement the liquid glass effect on top of native views, we would need the snapshot view to work at animation time. And so that's something we're going to address as well in this video. So this is why I'm really excited about Liquid Glass. Not really the effect in itself, but the fact that this is putting all together all the ingredients we know and love about React Native Skia. We're going to work with a simple button geometry here. We define a radius, and the whole button group geometry can be inferred from it. And we can apply a blur effect on the icon to get a nice transition. So here we have a circle and a rounded rectangle, But instead of drawing V's using draw circle and draw rounded rec, we are going to use a skier shader and the respective sine distance function of these shapes. The sine distance function of 2D shapes are given to us by Inigo Quiles, who has been an incredible evangelist of these shader techniques. He's also the founder of Shader Toy, where we could find many liquid glass examples. The influence of his work cannot be overstated, and one video I absolutely recommend from Inigo is painting a character with math. So for each pixel, we ask the question, how far am I from the shape? If the value is positive, we are outside the shape. If the value is negative, we are inside the shape. Hence the name sine distance function. For a circle, the math is very simple. It's the distance from the center minus the radius. For the rounded box, it's a bit harder and we'll use the formula directly, but Inigo has two videos on the topic to break down the math behind it. So now we have our SDF scene and we need the shapes to become liquid. And we're going to use an incredible tool for that called Smooth Minimum. Let's look at the case where the circle and the rounded rectangle overlap each other. We can merge the two using the min operation. For each pixel, what is the closest SDF? The circle or the rounded rectangle? That gives us this nice geometric shape. Or we can use the max operation to subtract one shape into another. Isn't math so beautiful? Let's plot the SDF for a second. On the x-axis, we have the coordinates, x and y equals 0. And on the y-axis, we have the SDF value. We have the graph for each one of our shapes, and we can take the mean that gives us a single function. What the smooth mean function does is to smooth out nice abrupt switches in values, and the resulting effect is this beautiful liquid effect. The smooth minimum has an extra k parameter we can use to decide how strong we want the effect to be. In a previous video, we had showcased how to transition from one shape to another, and back then we had showed how to either prepare the paths nicely so they can be interpolable, or to use a full tessellation of the paths, or even try to do it with image filters. But of course, if I were to redo this video today, I would certainly use SDFs and trying to use a smooth minimum to blend nicely the shapes with one another. In fact, just for fun, I wanted to morph from one shape to another using the smooth minimum, and I thought that I could get some pretty decent results. Not perfect by any means, but the fact that we're getting these for free is pretty incredible, I think. Now we have our liquid shape, and first we're going to use it to clip the backdrop filter. So let's apply a simple blur backdrop filter and to clip the shape. So here we cannot use a clipping path like we usually do in React Native Skia. We're going to use a blend mode. So if the pixels are transparent, we're going to filter out all the content from the backdrop filter. Here we're going to use a source in blend mode, which essentially acts as a logical end operator. Source in multiplies the alpha channel, so anything transparent on any of the sources will be transparent in the result. And of course, we can organize our image filters nicely as a tree. So for instance, we can have the blur image filter as a child, and we can also add a tint effect, so we can create a color and blend it using the source over blend mode. So the source over blend mode acts as a OR logical operator. It shows pixels from either the source or the destination. So that looks pretty cool, right? And so we have a nice liquid shape, and now we're going to build the light effect. It's going to be step three, and we're going to use a displacement map to do so. The way displacement map works in Skia is exactly the same as in SVG. We have two inputs, the source image we want to distort and a displacement map. We pick two color channels, one for the X displacement and one for the Y displacement. Each color represents a value from 0 to 1, where 0.5 means no displacement. Values from 0 to 0.5 are negative displacement, and values from 0.5 to 1 are positive displacement. And of course, we can set a scaling parameter to multiply the displacement. Pretty straightforward, right? So now what we want to do is to shade our liquid shape to create the effect. Here are a couple of displacement maps we can do. The first technique simulates how light bends when passing through curved glass. We use the shape's gradient, which tells us the surface angle at each point to determine how much to distort the image. The distortion is strongest at the edges where the glass surface is most angled and fades to nothing as we move away from the shape. Here we are creating a lens-like effect where the distortion gets weaker the further we are away from the edge. Inside the shape, we apply maximum distortion, but it quickly falls off as we move outwards. This creates a bubble or droplet effect. The exponential falloff gives us that smooth, natural transition from distorted to normal. As you can see, there are really different effects you can build with the displacement map. It really depends on how you build the displacement map itself. Here, we use the shader to build the displacement map using the SDF of the shape and its creation. So we had access to quite a powerful tool to get a lot of details. But I saw some examples on the web which were very simple and were yielding a very good result. Some are using noises, some are using a fixed displacement map. So I think really the most important thing to take away from this is how displacement maps work and just having fun with it. And so here we want now to use a custom shader, so to even like apply color effects and do things like color aberration that we couldn't do with a displacement map. And the shader we're going to use is a bit different than the regular shader in Skia. It's called the runtime shader in Skia, so the naming is a bit awkward, but what it means is that we're going to use a shader as an image filter. In a runtime shader, we get the content to be filtered as an input uniform. So for instance, here, we simply invert the color of the input. And some of the Skia image filters we know and love can easily be implemented using runtime shaders. The displacement map is one, for instance. However, when talking about image filters, one which I really want to always use Skia and not write it manually is usually the blur image filter, because Skia plays some trick to have really high performance blurs, and that would be quite cumbersome for us to rebuild ourselves and to have the same level of performance and quality. So going forward, every time we're going to need to blur the shape, we're going to use the Skia blur directly, and we're not going to blur things ourselves. So if we take, for instance, an example from Shader Toy that applies a blur, we're going to use our own image filter instead. So now we need a shader. There is a Shader Toy. And if we search for liquid glass, we can find some really interesting examples. Of all the liquid glass shaders on Shader Toy, one that really stood out to me is Optically Correct Liquid Glass by Metrowind. What caught my attention immediately is that the effect is pretty convincing, but also that Metrowind wrote a blog post to explain how the math behind the shader works. This was my favorite from the get-go. Whatever is the shader we pick, we need three things. First, the SDF of the liquid shape, and it's normal, so we have it using the gradient that we already used in the displacement map. And then we're going to probably need to blur the source input. So again, not blurring it ourselves, but using a Skia blur image filter for that. And by looking at Optically Correct Liquid Glass by Metrowind, the effect is based on the following parameters. Thickness, as if we were looking at a 3D glass from the top. Reflection index. And a tint color. So that looks pretty cool, right? And you can play with different versions of the effect. In fact, on iOS, depending on the context in which the effect is presented, you get different results. And here, Metrowind was really focused on the physicality of the effect. But of course, we can move away from it, from the physically correct version of the effect, to just build a nice effect. And I think that's what Apple is doing as well in the liquid glass example. And now let's have a look at 3GS, which has a transmission material, and I was interested to see if we could migrate the transmission material shader to Skia. Here are two versions of the liquid glass effect inspired by the mesh transition material from 3GS. In the first version, we try to closely migrate the GLSL shader from transmission material to Skia, and we get this nice grainy glass effect. And we also built a second version, which is just loosely inspired by the transmission material implementation. This one is actually my second favorite approach to achieve the liquid glass effect, the first one being the one I'm about to show you next. So a very, very simplified version of the transmission effect in 3GS. But again, you have different parameters which you can play with. And here, a last version of the shader, where the parameters have been specifically set to mimic the effect from Figma. So if a designer gives you a Figma design with liquid glass effect, you can use this version to reproduce it nicely in React Native Skia. And now let's talk about the elephant in the room. These examples only work because the content we're filtering is built with React Native Skia. We have the snapshot API and we were able to build incredible examples with it, but they have two constraints. First, the content behind the scene needs to be static. And then on Android, it is somewhat unstable. On iOS, we are trying to access the content of the view at a much lower cost that will allow for real-time animations. And on Android, we are looking at a new API from Android level 31 or above that allows us to apply Skia shaders directly as an image filter on a native view. So here it's not the Skia from React Native Skia, this is the Skia of Android, but since it is the same API, we think maybe we're going to be able to pass these values directly to the native Android Skia. And this might yield some really interesting results. And that's what I wanted to show you today, Liquid Glass Effect in React Native Skia. I was really excited to make this video because this is putting together all the things we know and love from React Native Skia. Advanced backdrop filter, building a liquid shape using the SDF and the smooth minimum. We built a nice shading on our shape to use it as a displacement map, which are a very convenient way to, simple and convenient way to build the effect. And we could also write our own custom shader as an image filter to build more advanced versions of the effect. We looked at versions from Shader Toy. We looked at the transmission material from 3GS, and we also tried to mimic the effects from Figma, so where we could have really a one-to-one transfer from a design to code. And then finally, we had a discussion on how to apply these effects as well on native view. This is an active area of work. So we hope to make progress soon, and we think we have some ideas on how these things can be improved. It's not really a Skia problem or React Native problem, it's more like a mobile development problem. How do people do this on Android, for instance? And we're gonna bring these APIs onto React Native Skia. So let me know what you think in the comments below. I am looking forward to talk to you soon, and until next time, happy hacking.